Right, today I'm doing the cake. I know I say that every single time, but I actually am doing absolutely everything. It's gonna be a double chocolate orange egg. It's not an egg. A double chocolate orange cake. So, you know, best way to get these open is do this. Like you're eating, you know, give it a good smack on the side there. Watch this. Do we need this open yet? No. Doing it right, we need it up. Ros is just here to supervise today. Obviously, she has to be here to supervise, otherwise, you know, who knows what could happen. Oh, it's dark chocolate, this. You've got dark chocolate. Do you know, so smashed on the sides. Look at that. Just drop the bits, look. Let's do the bones, Mum. What do the bones say? They say, put it in the bowl. Stop fucking pissing about, right? Oh, well, let's taste a bit of this.
Get off!
I'm not keen on that, though.
Quick! Dog's come and carry it.
Wait, get off. Quick blast from the tap. I could have put it straight in there, but I ain't getting dog lurgy. Right now what?
Right, you'll get your bowl out. I'll
melt
this for you.
What bowl? The bowl.
Yes!
The, right. I'm getting the bowl out. You know, the big old white favourite.
It's not the biggest job.
She just hit me with his spoon then. It was nothing like when we were little. Because I used to run upstairs crying. And then our Shelly used to get smacked across legs. And I was just sitting and laughing. Right, away. Right, go away.
Come on then, by now you want your skills out. By now you should know what you're doing.
I'm in a good mood today because it's Friday. And a very, very special person is on the train right now and she's on her way to see me. Well, I've forgotten what you said again. Was it flour or water?
Look. Get your scales out.
Scales. Right, here we are. Todd scales. Right, what are we on? 200. Great, right, 200. I'm using a spoon this time because
it's very soft.
I don't like waving knives about because it's dangerous. It's not dangerous, people don't like it. You know, get them feminist people, hey, you can't say that, you can't even do this. But anyway. Let's try and scoop 200 out of it. Let's try and scoop 200 out with one go. Please, will you just come and check if it's correct, Ros?
No, you want another.
Does that have to be 200?
200 there. 200 grams.
There's that many markers on this bloody scale. I don't know which is which. I don't know which is grams, milligrams, cubic centimetres or what. Oh, so sorry. I'm so sorry, Mum.
See that wooden spoon? Mum. You're going to get it on back of your neck in a minute. Oh, funny bugger, eh?
I'm sorry.
I'm not laughing.
The butter just flew off the knife and it stuck to the wall. Stuck to the wall. Sorry.
Leave it.
Sorry. One time we're having Sunday dinner, right? I'm not even lying now. And I got loads of tea on my spoon. I sat opposite my sister Tracy. And I just lobbed it straight out and it splattered all over her glasses. I mean, it was awful at the time for Tracy, but now, come on, Tracy, you have to have a laugh. It was hilarious. I was only about six or something. Right, this has to be perfect because it's on special. Is there any wonder when it's all bloody? It might as well be bloody liquid.
You know
butter.
Something, my son? I can do this without making a bloody mess there. So what's your problem?
I'm trying to keep things neat. That's why. Right, do I put this in that bowl, obviously? Now what? 200 grams of sugar?
Yes.
You should know all this, I do. 200 grams of butter, 200 grams of sugar. There we are. Look how fast I'm doing it. Now what, ma'am? Do I mix that together now with a spoon? Yeah, you mix that together. She didn't even answer me. I answered my own question there. We have got to mix them. I'd rather do it by hand because that last cake I made, that chocolate orange. I was a pig. Weren't I, ma'am?
I had a piece. My husband had a piece, Charlie, and his sister Michelle had a piece, and he ate the rest.
Sorry. It was so nice, right? I had one piece of it. And do you know when you eat something and you're like, I don't want this to end me. I kept on eating it. Do you know what I was like? I don't know if anybody's seen that film Matilda. Have you seen Matilda?
Of course I have.
There's that little boy, and she makes him eat that chocolate cake in all in front of all kids, and they're all like, come on! What's it called? That was like me the other day, chocolate all over my face. Sat in cupboard under the stairs eating my cake that I made.
You weren't under the stairs.
Yes, I was.
No, you were not. I didn't have a job fitting under there.
I was sat under the stairs eating his cake by myself. It was all over the place, I'm telling you. That's why I'm having to like blast under the cake together now. No, this is for somebody. I'm making a cake for somebody. This ain't looking very good, this. It doesn't look as good as it normally does. I say. What do you think?
Look at that.
Hey, look at this. 4 eggs, right? It weighs bang on 200 grams. So, we've got 200 grams of the full pure egg. You know, the paste. Watch this then, straight in. Yeah. I can't stand this music. What is it?
Alexa, stop.
Alexa, play disco music.
No.
Alexa, play disco.
She's not answering
that. Here's a station you might like. Disco on Amazon Music.
I love disco. And I've put the eggs in. And look at this. I don't know if you can see it from there, but I haven't broke any of the yolk.
You get on with it?
Ma'am, there's no rush.
No, but your chocolate's going hard again.
Where? Chocolate's going hard again. We've cheated. My mum's cheated. She put it in the microwave. How did you do? Pardon me. Excuse me. How did you do everything properly? But no, we have to rush and cut corners. When you microwave something, right, it bakes everything out of the product that you're putting in there. Do you know all this? Because it's radiation, that's why. It's microwave radiation. This looks terrible, this, ma'am. When do I put this flour in?
Next. That looks good, now put your flour in.
It's not. It has to be right. The moisture it mixes, the more muscle you give it, the nicer it tastes.
Yeah,
I should know. Just eating a full cake to myself. Get away. I don't believe it. Last bit back. Guess how much it weighs. Come on, you all know by now. 200 big ones. Right, Mama, where?
Oh, we can have pigeon pie. There's a big fat pigeon in garden.
I'm not into eating bird pie, Mum.
I was joking.
No, you weren't. Went in the garage one day, I walked into a pheasant that was hanging upside down, then I shit myself. What's it like, Mum, it's shave? I walked in, what's that? Ooh. And then I realised, I was like, ugh. Started pulling feathers out. Why does it look, so, like, sicky? What?
Well, I'm getting flour in now.
Right. I'm going to get the flour in right now. 200 grams, remember, straight in.
You're making a mess.
remember Buck Rogers? Remember Buck Rogers?
Yeah,
there was a little
robot.
He had like a little robot android mate. He had a little thing on here, like, didn't he, Mum?
Yeah.
He used to walk about going, biggie, 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 biggie. Didn't he?
Yeah.
How funny is that?
It's his shirt now.
Mum, it doesn't matter.
It does that. I have to wash it.
Listen, it comes off. It's only cream de la crème. Right. We're bashing on now with this flour mix. This is your... the flour part is the messiest bit, if you ask me. It looks good.
Are you joking? Look at the kitchen.
Mum, it's looking good. Just thinking of... think of the end product. Nice big fat cake.
Why? You'll eat it all.
Nice big fat cake to have afternoon tea with. I'm full of cack. We don't even have afternoon tea. We should though. You know, like have a tea and have a finger like this. Pass us a bit of that cake you made, will you? Get away. We can go. Mama, sorry. Go on. There's not many bakers left like me, I'm telling you that right now. Tom, sorry. Yeah, listen to me. It's all about the preparation. It's like everything you do when you're building it, like an house and stuff like that. It's all about the groundwork, preparation. If you don't get that right, your house doesn't sit right. I'm telling you that right now. Good tip for you there. Always get your foundations bang on.
Right, get your chocolate in
the pipe now. As you can see, we've melted the chocolate, cheated in a bowl. I mean, in a jug.
Just scoop it in.
Whoa.
Don't you dare.
Right.
Get it in.
Hey, ouch. This is the worst tool.
Do you want me to do it?
Yeah, stop, have a go. I know I said I was going to do everything, but just little fiddly bits like that, it won't even come out. It smells absolutely fantastic. Oh, I've got bellyache thinking of, not bellyache. Yeah, I've got hunger pains.
Oh.
Right. Every single tiny bit you can get out
I'm
of that.
I'm going to. Go on then.
Right. Back on with stirring again. Remember, the more you stir it, the nicer it tastes in the end.
Do you know what, everyone? His niece has been baking with me since she was about 4 years old, and her cakes are absolutely wonderful. She's now 12, and even though she was a little thing, my kitchen was never like this.
Yeah, but the thing is, Tyler, you might be 12 years old, but your cakes don't even come close to tasting like...
Yes, they do!
You know I like to win, Mum.
Well, sorry, but Tyler's are beautiful.
Yeah, my little niece, Tyler, that's how her shell's burned. She's fantastic, she's very talented. She'd see a draw, she must get it all from me, I think she does. She's a fantastic artist, she's a fantastic baker. And, you know, I think she just gets it all from her uncle.
Did you not think that maybe the baking came from her grandma?
Maybe the baking came from grandma, but obviously, my baking's been passed down from my mum, so she's passed to my...
But you've never baked with Tyler.
Yeah, because no one lets me.
Do you blame us?
You know I know one wants me in the kitchen, don't you? Because you just outdo them all.
No,
yes, I do.
Because you make such a bloody mess.
I outdo all your cakes, and I do it all by hand. Best way, Mum, honest. Fuck the mixers. You can see it when you can see it closer when you're doing it. Remember a few months ago, I snapped my wrist in half. It's getting so strong and powerful again now.
Right, your air fryer oven is ready.
Look at that.
Right, half and half in these. Come along. Don't you dare eat it. Half and half. You're better off using that thing.
I disagree. I totally disagree with using that red thing. It's like a bloody... It's like a piece of rubber that's just bent.
Eggshells on the floor. Chocolate everywhere.
It's like hover rod.
It's great, isn't it? Well, somebody has to clear up, because it won't be you.
Do you remember that game they used to play up Green Lane called Tally-O? Do you remember?
Of course I do. I was playing Tally-O before you.
Right then. Ross, if you know...
Not up Green Lane,
if you know what Tally-O is, tell us the rules, because I don't fucking know what they are.
I don't think there is any rules.
What's the point of having a game, right, and having no fucking rules? I used to just walk around going, Tally-O! You know, and nothing used to happen.
They all run away from
you. And then you hear someone else shout something else, you're like... Is that someone in my game, or is it someone just in the street pissing about? You've got Tally-O! Tally-O! No one there. Looks absolutely fantastic, this cake mix. It's a long video, this one. I know we only do 10 minutes, but might as well just keep the fucking cameras rolling. Sorry for swearing, but it just comes out of me. Right away. We aren't putting these on Facebook and TikTok and crap anymore.
Oh, whatever, John. Right,
put
them in your oven.
So we've got two bases. We've got two bases here, a beautiful made, handmade mixed chocolate Alicante Bakewell tarts.
Isn't that a place, Alicante?
What, ma'am?
Isn't that a place?
All right, we've got two bases of Ola Rouge. Nice chocolate. Oh, I don't bloody know what they're called.
I've never made an Ola Rouge in my life.
We've got chocolate Battenberg. We'll call it that if you want. Right, let's get it in the fucking oven. Where is it? Is it ready to go now?
Yeah.
What, top and bottom?
Yeah.
There we are. Whoa. Top and bottom. Mammy, are you sure that's alright?
Yeah, just put the timer on.
How long?
I don't know, put on 30 minutes. I can always keep my eye on it. Right, there you go.
Yeah. Speed, high, medium or low?
Medium.
Right, we're using the new air fryer again here. I'll come over. Ross, tell them what you think of air fryer.
I love it. Absolutely love it.
Yeah, apparently everyone's going out and buying these new cookers. Not cookers, air fryers.
No, that one's an air fryer oven.
Sorry, that's an air fryer oven. Get it right. You know, Ross treated herself, she didn't get much, so... I'm saying, that there's this other version you can get. It's like a little chip pan, it looks like a little chip pan, right?
That's an air fryer.
Yeah, it's like a chip pan. And you pull the drawer out, put your chips in, bang it in. Air fry it, bang, like McDonald's. But this one over here is different. That's gross, got a coffee mouth.
Yeah. Because this one doesn't just air fry, it bakes as well.
This one doesn't just air bake, I mean air fry. It air fries, bakes.
Toast.
Broil, whatever
and
that...
And keeps them as
warm. Broil, whatever that means. I think
boil.
Someone taught me it was an American phrase. It has a grill on it. Do you know what I'd love? Some of them barbecue ribs they have on Man vs Food, and proper American ribs that they have. Dripping with barbecues. Where the fuck do we get them from? You can't get them wrong, do you?
Neither.
You can't even get them at butchers. You're walking like we don't do them.
Yes, you can. My butchers, you can.
You can't?
Yes, you can. Because I've seen them in
the
shop.
I'm doing this right because people tell me to. I don't know why. But people just seem... I don't know what it is about me. You either love me or you hate me. I've got loads of haters out there. God, you won't believe how much, like, you won't believe how many people hate me. I never thought.
And that's quite sad because they don't know you.
It is quite sad because they don't know me.
I don't hate anybody.
Neither do I, Ros. I don't hate anyone. I ain't got time to hate anybody. You know? I mean, who gets up in the morning and thinks, I hate so and so, I hate you, I hate him, I hate that?
Because they've got nothing else in their
life. Life's too short to hold grudges, everybody.
Absolutely.
You need to let it all go and just get on with it. Having grudges and that, I've been angry with people.
I look at it like this, you don't get a ring done, this is it. So you might as well have a good time while you're here. And just be nice.
Yeah, listen to Ros, you know what she's talking about.
I don't care what colour people are, they can be sky blue, pink, the yellow dots on. If they're nice to me, I'll be nice to them.
There is people like that out there, ma'am. Aliens, they have blue skin. There's reptilians, there's also. Anyway, it's all there,
there's
it's all.
Fucking reptilians. Oops, sorry.
Did you hear Ros then using that F word? Wait till Nana sees this to be bloody hell on. I know she calls me a Hey, ma'am.
What?
Do you remember that programme called V? We used to watch it in the 80s years ago.
Called what?
V.
Oh, yeah. That's still on.
Is it?
Yeah.
I'm talking about the original version,
it's
right?
It's still on, if you want to watch it.
Well, V is about these aliens, reptilians, actually. Yeah. See, they were going on about the reptilians in the 80s. So it's obviously all true. They've been trying to like break us into it slowly and slowly, you know, from all these like sci-fi movies and all that. They've been trying to like just break us into it gently, because all that shit really happens.
I haven't got chocolate on the kettle.
They reckon there's 13 civilizations just in our Milky Way. You know what I mean?
Henry.
Palladians, they live 400 light years away. 400 light years. So let's think about this. If you wanted to go to their house, right, you'd have to travel 200,000 miles per second.
That's light years.
Every day for 400 years to get there. Now, come on. There must be...
400 years?
The Palladians, they live 400 light years
All
away.
Right.
They live 400... Ros ain't even listening, she's butting in right and just spoiling everything. She don't even know what I'm talking about. But if you don't...
You know what, John, I think you're an alien.
I am, listen to me.
So I'm not quite sure where I got you from.
There's a book out there called Chariots of the Gods by Eric von Daniken. Everyone should read it.
I've read it.
Ros has read it. It just opens your eyes. All these mainstream scholars, man, they haven't got a clue. They think they know everything. Oh yeah, ancient people built the pyramids.
Who is it does?
With hammer and chisels and that, and carried all blocks over on the backs and put them all in place. Did the fuck? I'm telling you now, them pyramids have been here longer than man. And they were here because they were a power station. People might think I'm crackers, right? But this bloke was allowed to go into.
Well, I told Sonia, didn't I?
Oh.
Tesla,
yeah, Nikola Tesla.
He knew.
We aren't even taught about Nikola Tesla at school. And he's one of the most brilliant men to ever walk this earth. He had over 700 patents, man. Some of his inventions, well, he electrified the whole goddamn world.
And then took it off him.
They did? His ideas, right, he wanted to make sure that everybody had free electricity or wireless. You know, wireless electricity, like you have your fucking Bluetooth, but instead you'd have it electricity. They've got the technology, they just won't let us have it. And when I say they, I mean the like, either like the government or the Illuminati. On the door! Listen to me, I'm trying to like, you know, just get through this thing. I'm waiting for the cakes. That way, how long we're talking now, have a look. Did we say we're going to get a coffee here or what?
I don't want one, no, thank you. I want you to put them away, though.
Are we finished now?
Yeah. Apart from that one.
The
scales can go away.
So, that's just about it. We're just going to wait for the cakes to come out of the oven. I can't do anything else, really, because, can I do anything else when it comes out of the oven, Mama?
Yeah, well, no, you'll have to wait till it cools.
I can't be talking for that long. Well, I could.
Yeah, you could.
Excuse me, pardon me.
I'm going now.
Where are you going?
The sitting room.
Oh, you know.
I don't know if there's anybody out there like me. You're a bit of Blondie, come on radio and you're like... And you're like... Just lay her out. I'd never hurt her. Anyway, what about the second mix? The chocolate mix, can I do that?
Yeah, yeah.
Right, I'm gonna get on with the chocolate mix for the top and that. Where is it? Where is it? In this? I need the easiest thing that we need. I need the easiest one. Right, we're going to do the topping now, the best bit, it's absolutely mint. The other day I was just scraping it off like this and just... Remember, if you've got no sugar, excellent substitute. Right, how are they?
I wouldn't like it in my coffee.
Oh shit, look. I'll do it again for you. I've got another chocolate orange here, Terry's. This is the best way to smash them open.
I think people know.
Get a bit of power behind you. Sorry, ma'am. Nearly laid her out with them my ass. Here. Just one it. That's all it takes.
You only want half.
I'm just putting all of it in.
You only want
half. Why? It's a special cake for a special somebody. And that music is loud. It's too loud. Right, ma'am. Can I please just put the full orange in?
Oh, John, do what you want.
Right. Did you want half to eat for yourself, like?
No, I don't eat chocolate!
Did you? Well, what did you want the other half for?
Well, in case we make another cake.
Get down, Molly!
Leave them be.
What do you think? Should we put the full... Anyway, look, remember, I gave it a good smash on side, didn't I? Here, look at this. We've got chocolate for everyone. Look at that. So when you're pissing about at Christmas Day and you open your chocolate orange that you get for Christmas or for your nana or your Auntie Sue or whatever, and you open it up and you're pissing about trying to open it, before you can open the wrapper, just give it a smash on the side. And it's all ready. Right, ma'am. I'm going to count it out, make it equal so she gets half and half goes on my cake. So there's 5, 6, 7, 9, 9, 10, 11. 8 odd numbers? How can it be odd? Sorry, ma'am, but it's odd.
It's like you then.
You got a chocolate orange, yeah, did you know the segments? I'm just counting them out, isn't it? It's an odd number. Is it really? I don't know. I won't even count them properly. Anyway, I'm just going to put them all in, fuck it. If my mum wants to make another cake, I can sharpen up to a Lidl and get a couple more. They're only a fucking pound each on the shelf out there, on special offer. 99p, and get fat. I'll go up and get 8. I'll go up and get 8 quid's worth. Right, we're doing alright here, Ross. For time, we're flying down. We're flying through it.
Well, I didn't want to walk up at toilet, but that ain't going
to happen. I'm going to wear this. What about this?
No.
This is the best bit, the chocolate surrounding, whatever it's called, is that right?
What?
The chocolate surrounding is the
icing.
Icing. One day we're going to make one of the massive cakes, like I said the other day, do you know, for somebody's wedding. About this big. Takes 3 years to carry it out to the car, like this, you know what I mean? Here's your wedding cake. Whose wedding cake did you make that time? It weighed about 10 tonne. Was it mine?
No, it was Nicky's.
My mum made someone's wedding cake, right? I think she was called Nicky.
She's called Nicky,
I'm sorry. So Nicky, remember that wedding cake my mum made you?
Yeah, it was that one with the top hat, sitting in the bottom.
It was that hot. It all started caving in. We're out talking about that.
I made Shelley's as well.
We had to go get Jeff Capes round to carry it up to the car for us. It weighed that much.
Really?
Even Jeff struggled. He was like, fucking hell, what's in this? And my mum was like, it's just pure chocolate. Anyway, can we do...
I made Shelley's. I made all the
flammers
and everything with
Michelle's. Right. So yeah, let's go for the cakes, what my mum's made for people. What's that girl called you just talked about?
Nikki.
Right, Nikki, what was your cake like? Brilliant. So it was Nikki, we did Nikki's cake. We did our Shelley's together, didn't we, Mum?
You did not help me at all with Michelle's. You weren't even living here then.
Apparently I didn't even live here then, but I would have helped. Hey, who was that cake that you made? My mum made the cake, right, and it was like a fairy house, but it was a mushroom-shaped fairy house. And it had
Tyler's birthday.
Yeah, sorry. Can you tell? I really like that song. It's good. Yeah. Anyway, back to the cakes. So there was Nikki, our Shelley. She made Tyler a little mushroom house that I helped make the fairies.
I made Zach, Noah's Ark.
She made Zach and Noah's Ark. We made Dale a skateboard that time. Do you remember that skateboard we made?
I made our Dan a swimming pool.
So we did a skateboard. We made our Dan a swimming pool.
I made him that truck, Eddie Stobart truck.
She made him an Eddie Stobart truck cake. She made me a record cake when I was younger. Do you remember?
21.
I was 21?
Yeah,
for
your 21st birthday.
She made me this record cake, right? I had jam and all sorts and it sponged lovely. I didn't get one piece, right? And guess who ate it all? One person ate a lot of it. My little sister, Michelle. And don't deny it, right? Because she even told me that she did it. John, I'm so sorry, I just took the whole tin in my bedroom and ate it all. That was my birthday cake, I didn't get one piece, but I ain't bothered, I don't hold grudges. Like I said earlier, we ain't got time to hold grudges.
I did Wayne's 40th.
Wayne's 40th? So that's about, I've got about, bloody hell, I'm running out of fingers here.
I made a little black and white cap for somebody at work.
Little black and white cap for someone at work. You've made loads of cakes, you used to make... She used to make them every week. I'd like to make cakes for people. Look, if you want to get in touch with me, just get in touch with me and say, John, I want you to make me this cake. And if you showed me a picture, I bet I could do it identical. And if I did it for somebody else, and I was fucking covered. If I was baking a cake for somebody and they were paying me, it'd be absolutely perfect for you. Because that's what I'm like. It has to be. Say if I baked you a cake and you were paying me and I finished it, it didn't look right. I'd put my fist straight through it and I'd start again. I'd be like, fuck that, I can't give them that. How can I give them that, mum? I'm gonna start again, fuck it. She'd be like, no, you can't. You know, you fucking look at steak kitchen, you can't start again. But that's what we're like. So, you know, if you want any cakes doing, I'll be more than happy to have a go at it for you. I've got some brilliant ideas. I'm an artist. I don't know, Mum.
What about that big sunflower I made with the butterflies on it? That was beautiful, that one.
She made a massive sunflower cake with butterflies all over it. It was mint. We've got loads of ideas. You know that, have you seen the King of Cakes, Queen of Cakes, or King of Kings, whatever it's called?
I like Buddy.
What's it, who's it, Mum?
Buddy.
Buddy, you?
I don't know, he's in America.
Your cake, man?
Yes, sir.
There's a guy in America called Buddy, he makes cakes, my mum likes him, but I've told her we could be mint, I'll do all the hard shit, all the boring stuff, you know, like rolling all the fucking icing out and all that crap. Like rolling all the icing out and on.
All you have to do is make a shape with sponge. That's all I do. They make a shape with sponge, right? I don't know. Let's say you wanted a shark cake. You're like a big fucking shark. You make a sponge something like, and then you make it like into a shark shape, and then you just bang your icing over the top, you know, tuck it all in as if you're tucking someone in a sleeping bag, and then just colour it, because you can paint, can't you paint different colours than that?
I made birthday cake for somebody and then I put a John Deere tractor on it. John Deere tractor.
John Deere tractor cake. I'm running out of. I'm honestly. I'd like to make like a princess's castle cake. That's what I'd like. John, are you a man or a woman? Obviously, I'm a man. But you know, I spent most of my life with my sisters and my mum. So you can't blame me for liking things like that, can you? Come on. I was dressed up as a girl the other week. I'm not bothered. I'm not a cross-dresser or anything like that, right? But I did it because I could. I went on my live on my TikTok, right? I had all this beautiful makeup put on my eyes. I had really nice lipstick on because I've got really nice lips. Well, I've been told they are. And I had a selection of wigs. There was loads. So I chose this blonde wig and I was doing my live. And it looked like somebody told me I was doubling my sister. I was like, oh my God, I'm so like... I was fucking, you know, what a compliment.
What do you think?
I never saw it.
Ros reckons that she never saw it.
I never saw it.
I have got a picture of it somewhere on my phone, but you know. Some people might think that's weird, getting dressed up like a girl or... What do we do with this?
Get your doodad. You want your thing there.
Oh, fuck me. We have to do that sieving thing again. This smells like an absolute dream. I could just fall into it and just put it all over my face. And go, you know, like a face mask with chocolate. Ooh! But you know I don't eat chocolate. I do sometimes, now and again. John, you're full of shit. We saw you eating chocolate the other day in that cake video. You were sucking that spoon dry, we saw you. Did you see that? Never mind, right. I know what I'm doing. I like it. It's good. The thing is with me, the more technical with these cakes, the more technical, the more better for me. Because my head, it gets bored. It's like, I'm getting bored of doing these stupid fucking, you know, sponge on sponge cakes. I'm getting bored of it.
I am.
Mam, I've told you. I'll stand here and make as many bloody buns and cakes, scones, flapjacks.
Too slow, John. I'd rather do it myself and get
a... I'm going as fast as I can. I've made a cake this morning in about 2 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
So there's a bit of fucking flour outside. It doesn't matter. I could sharp sweep that up, right? So, you know, you have to stab this in. Oh, remember this? Reminds me of a bit of school disco. Just to the side by myself. With all my hand-me-downs on from our lads. John, shut up. I'm telling truth. Any other cat? Do you remember school disco, ma'am? The DJ at East Whitby School there, she used to come and do the music. She never used to have any headphones. All she had was this fucking telephone, right? Because we were so little and didn't understand. We were like, why is she on the phone all the time? She's supposed to be doing the music. She's never ever off the phone. But she was listening to the next song. So, you know. For so long. I'll tell you a secret now. I'll tell you a little secret about what I used to do when I was little. To this song, I mean. I used to pretend I was in the video and sing it, you know, like in my bedroom window, like. Do you know, like try and do a bit of acting and that? Then I'd be like. You know, I don't know if anybody's like me, but come on. You must have sat at home and pretended that you're in a music video.
Tell you what, John, I'm going to Yeah? I
don't think there's anybody like you. Yeah, there is, man. I can loads of people can relate to me. You know, everybody's like had a sat in the bedroom window pretending.
Anybody want him for a week?
She's trying to give me away for the week. Nobody'd have me. I've got nowhere to go. I've got nowhere else to go, have I, Ros? I'm like fucking Stig of the Dunk. I've got nowhere to go. But, what was I saying? You've made me forget what I was talking about now, man.
Stig
of the Dunk. No! Yeah, everybody's like pretended to be in a music video. Of course they have. Even when you're pissed off and depressed and you put a sad song on your satin window, like, you know what I'm talking about. You must do. We're all the same. I don't mind telling you though, because I know we're all alike. Apart from them people who hate people. I don't get it. I don't get how people can walk around hating people they don't even know. I just can't get my head round that. Mum, do I need more ice and sugar in there? I'm doing dog shit. Well, sure, listen to me. Look at that. That's the biggest Ferrero Rocher you'll ever see in your life, mate. It's a nice piece of chocolate. Mum, I don't think there's enough for you, like. I was expecting double that for top and sides.
You don't do it sides, John. How many times do I have to tell you?
Can't we add like a bit?
No, because when you get hold of it, you stuck up to eyeballs.
Can't we add a bit of water and a bit more ice and sugar to make it
tiny?
To make more.
Tiny.
What water? You'll get a bit in a cup then, how much you think? Can I put some more of this in? Do you reckon I should sieve in another sieve or not? Here. Oh, I'm definitely going to have to put another fucking sieve in now. If she's ruined my cake by putting all this water in here and it tastes funny, I'll be very, very upset.
That'll do.
Willy Wonka won't be fucking very impressed. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing?
Here. I thought.
He's like, you like coming to work at my factory, you know, good. Oompa Loompas are better than you.
Mate?
Well, yeah.
Oompa Loompas are better than me.
They do what they're told, little bastards. Have you seen that new what's it called? What the fuck is it called? Willy Wonka in the Chocolate Factory. With Johnny Depp. It's weird as hell, man. Them little men. They're supposed to be Oompa Loompas, but it's the same bloke. I can't wait to what's it like?
Not ready yet.
Oh, Grace. We should. Remember, we're using that new air fried bake oven. We've got it on bake. It's not quite ready yet. Shit, look at this now, it's horrible. Looks horrible, that.
I think this one's better.
It might look horrible, but the more you stir it, the nicer it looks. How thick does this need to be? Does it need to be like it was the other day?
Yeah.
That's like water, that.
That one's ready, it's beautiful.
Don't know if you can see that. Turn it. There we are, look. There's my first one done. I don't know if you can see it. Can imagine if it flew off and went straight into the sink, I'd be gutted. Listen to what happened one day, right? We sat at a table. My mum was sat at a table with a tea and it was egg, chips and sausage, right? And beans. My mum was sat at a table there. And I walked in, right? I went to sit down and I dropped my fucking tea. It flipped over onto the table, right? I lifted my plate up and it was all sat on table, perfect. You know, like it was on the plate. So I had to just pick it back off, but how funny is that? I was like, how lucky was that it landed on the table and that not on the fucking floor? Lots of dustbins that have got it straight away. You know, alligators waiting. Vultures, whatever you want to call them, little bastards. Telling you, dogs, man. So yeah, that's the bottom, that's the base cake done. How long did it take? Did it take half an hour, Mal?
Took about
20 minutes in the new air fryer, oven bake, spoil boil, fucking toast and boil thing.
So you didn't listen to me, you've gone and put it on high and it should have been on medium. Why didn't you listen to me? Never listened.
Did anybody hear us tell me the instructions to put on that oven, like the heat or the speed or the temperature? No! You didn't even say anything, Mum. You go, put that in there. 30 minutes will do, that's all you said to me. Oh, look at this. What time is it? Oh, fucking hell, what time I have to... I have to be down at the train station at 3:35.
It's 1:10.
I know it's 1:10, but you know, I have to go to the shower, get ready, make myself look beautiful. Well, oh, fuck off, listen to this. We're on it now, guys. Mum? Sorry, I can't help it. I can't see my socks. Ross knows it. And remember, everyone, well, I've been serious about these cakes for you, you know. John, just do that chocolate. You got Mum?
No, I can't put it on yet,
they aren't cooled down. I know this has been a... My dog's having a shit in garden, he doesn't normally do that, but... Well, I don't know why, he's already been... I'll tell you why. Ros never stops feeding him treats. She spoils them rotten, and the farts, it stinks in the house of dog fart, all the time. But you know,
hey,
people tell me I've got the gift of the gab, so I can, you know, people have been telling me, and all. I mean, is that still recording this? Shit, yeah, it's still recording. Yeah, people say to me, listen, people say to me, right, things, I'm going to tell you what people say to me. People say to me, John, do you know what Big Brother is? I'm like, well, I've seen a couple of episodes years ago. Why? I'm like, you need to apply to go in there. I'm like, why though? Because you'll fucking win, that's why. You stop telling me what to do, Ros.
You stop swearing.
I'm nearly 45 years old in December. I ain't got time to hold grudges, call people names, I ain't got time to hate people, I ain't got time to do anything apart from think positively and, you know, try and make people smile and be happy. That's the main thing, isn't it, Mum?
Yeah.
Look after Ros, I'll do that for Ros if I can. Yes, I fucking do. I saw her then. Do you know what I mean? But this is like an advertisement, look, from the cake business. You all know I'm not allowed to go to work anymore. What?
No, because you're fucking dangerous. Sorry, swearing.
I miss going to work, of course I do. I miss all my workmates and we used to have a fucking mint laugh. Do you walk around going, allow it, yeah? Allow it, man? Do you know what, when I was scaffolding that, without scaffolders?
Yeah, you fell off.
Yeah, and then he broke me back and broke my shin off, you know, doing... Anyway, it's what I'm going, allow it, yeah? Get me, yeah? Feel it, yeah? In it, fam? It's in that pan, Sam. Where, man? There, man. Yeah, fam? You know what I mean?
I don't know if I like these cakes.
Why? They're good?
Yeah, they're nice.
What's up with them?
Nothing. Tastes nice.
Have you noticed she's saying she doesn't like them, right? Sorry. You know why, don't you? Mum, don't be jealous of my cakes.
I'm not.
Well, stop criticising them then.
I'm going. You can crack on yourself.
No, don't. You can't.
I can crack. You can crack on yourself because it's upsetting me seeing yapping and... You can't put that on there till the cooler and it's going to take a good hour.
Oh, fuck. It's going to take a good... I can't stand here talking for an hour. Well, I
no,
could...
You can.
I could easy. I could easy stand here talking to you for an hour. I could stand here and talk to you for like, I could stand here and talk to you for the rest of your life if you wanted me to. But I haven't got many subscribers though, you know. I haven't even had a look at my, let's have a look at this chocolate. I made this myself. Isn't that beautiful? Look at this. God, my mouth's watering. Ooh. Yes, so today, I have to go meet somebody off the train and I'm gonna get dressed up really nice. But I hope you'll listen to me. I don't know what people think of me. Telling you now, if you like chocolate orange and you want a cake doing, I'm the person you need to get in touch with, and I'm being so serious. I'll be like the new cake boss of Whitby. I don't know who the cake boss is at the moment. I'm sure there is one out there, and if you're watching this, sorry mate, but I want to be the boss now. So you know, if you're friends with me on Facebook and you watch this and you find, I'm not putting this on Facebook, it's shit. This is all going on YouTube, this man. I like YouTube. You can just load, you can just make videos that are like, I don't know, fucking 2 hours long and bang them on and just leave it, you know what I mean? What I'm saying, the cakes I make, I just do it quick, you know, I don't rush. But I'm not really bothered, my head's not really with it, do you know what I mean? Because I'm talking all the time, but if someone said to me, John, got in touch with me and said, John, look, be serious now, will you make me a crocodile cake? I'd be like, of course I fucking will. And don't forget, I'm an artist. I'm fantastic at art. I love it. Art was the only class I'd go to at school. I used to hate every other lesson. Sorry. I did. I've just scraped that off the side of the bowl, right? I mean, if you bit into your cake, there's no wonder why I had that other cake. Was it even lying? I cut 2 pieces out there so the cake looked like Pac-Man. You know what I mean? Bang, 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 bang. It looked like that. But the cake, I just fucking ate the lot. I ate it and I was like, this is the nicest cake I've ever had in my life. Sorry if I've got brown teeth, I've been eating chocolate, but yeah, I'm telling you, I can do any cake. I'd like to make a wizard's hat cake, you know, it looks like a giant wizard's hat, but no. Make like a profiterole like stack. Fuck off. One, two, three, four. You know, like make a profiterole stack that looks like a, you know, like this. A spiral. So you get a spiral of profiteroles, right? Put them on some kind of base, and then no. make a profiterole roll spiral, right? But you'd need it on some kind of a base, wouldn't you? You know, for the wizard's, for the bottom of the wizard's hat, for the rim. So we need something for the rim. Alexa, turn it down. So we need profiterole rolls on some kind of, like, on some kind of, on some kind of base. And then what I'd do is roll out the icing sugar dead thin. As thin as I could get it before it started tearing, you know. And then I coat the profiterole rolls with that to make it, you know, so it did look like a wizard's hat, and I'd bend it and, I'd shape it and stuff, because to look like a wizard's hat, I'm talking massive. I'm talking like Gandalf size, you know, Gandalf out of fucking Lord of the Rings. Like his hat in real life, it'd be massive. It'd be about that big, wouldn't it? Bent over. Well, that's what I'd like to do, a cake like that. Can you imagine how nice that'd be? If you cut into icing and you cut through all the profiteroles as well. I don't know if that'd work, but maybe it would, maybe it wouldn't. I don't know if you'd need sponge in it or... I'm new to all this baking, like, you know. Of course I am. But I just really like doing it. It's relaxing, it's nice, it's good. But like I say, every time I ever go on my TikTok, I go live and someone reports me for being a bully. I mean, me, a bully. I haven't got a bad bone in my body, have I? People hate me for no reason. I tell you what it is, people. People hate me because I look after myself and I'm not a bad looking person and I can talk very well. No. Not very well. I can talk a lot. You know, I've done a lot of things in my life, so, and I don't mind telling you about them. And that's what people don't like. Other people that don't like me, who hate me, they've never done anything with their lives. They've just sat on the sofa all their lives, not bothered going out to get a job. And then when they come, and you know, then they just play computer games. And they're like keyboard warriors, and they rip me to pieces. But the thing is, it doesn't bother me because the places I've been and seen with my own eyes, it's just amazing, fantastic. There's a whole world out there. You know, there's more to life than playing Call of Duty and trolling people on TikTok. I'm telling you that right now. There's so much more to life than that. You need to get out. Get out in the fresh air. Oh, by the way, hello to my mate John Franklin. John, you know I love you, mate. He's from bloody Nottingham, like. You know, he were new to town. Well, he were new to me, and I met him. I can't remember. Oh, yeah. We got talking down front, didn't we, John? And we just seemed to get on because he used to be a fireman, lifesaver and that lot. And when I were working, I used to work for British Telecommunications. So, you know, we're both grafters. But John, yeah, I know I'm shit at doing your accent, but I hope you're well, mate. He is, actually. He's doing really well. He's, I was talking to him last night and he's really happy and that's really good. I think he's getting on a bit now. No, sorry for saying that. He's about, shit. He's not even 60. But I can't mix this anymore. But, I mean, can I stand here and talk for an hour? Everyone's thinking, I thought he didn't eat chocolate. I don't, that's why it's so nice to me. Honestly, I think the longest I went without eating chocolate is like 8 months without touching it. I don't know, when lockdown started, I was overweight, me, you know. The lockdown started, I was a 36 inch waist, yeah? I had a double chin, I had a pair of tits, I had a muffin top round my back, you know, when I used to fasten my jeans up, I had a muffin top. So lockdown started, I thought, I'm not staying in Northam. So while everybody was locked in the houses on the lockdown, me and my dog were marching 10 miles every day before dinner. Before dinner. So we used to get up, leave the house at 6 o'clock and do military style marching. That's like 30 inch stride, you know. And I was doing it to the beat of the music constantly until the 10 miles was up. And you won't believe how much beef I lost. And obviously like when I was on the Scar, and that's where, like, that's a place in Whitby where, you know, when the tide goes out, there's no beach, it's just all rock. It's called the Scar. And I used to go on there and just teach myself how to dance. Like, everything, when there was no... The only thing that used to see me was the seagulls and the odd seal that was laid on the ground. I'd be thinking, what the fuck's he doing jumping about like that? So, you know... So from the lockdown until now, that's how far I've come with me dancing. I don't think I've done bad actually. I think I'm at the level now where I'm ready to teach people. Stop eating that, it's too much. So I'll do your cakes for you. Any design you want, anything. You know, from crocodile to the sun shape, anything you want. What else can I do? Dancing. I don't think people think I'm serious. Honestly, people got in touch with me and said, you know, my daughter wants you to teach her to dance, or my son wants to learn how to dance, or I want to learn how to dance, or will you teach us all how to dance? I'd get a hall or something, like I'd hire somewhere. You know, like I'd hire somewhere out and I'd do classes. I mean, it'd be a good laugh. Can you imagine doing dance class with me? Eh? Like this. Oops. I tell you what, I'm gonna pull that fucking cupboard door off of my pocket in a minute. I absolutely love dancing, me. Do you know? I got invited to make a video for JD Sports for TikTok, yeah? I only fucking won. 500,000 people watched it in one morning. So, you know, that was good. But I'm gonna go now because, it's gonna be ages before they cool off. But I'll restart it again when I'm doing the icing and I'm gonna... Hey, Ross is back. Can we do it yet or not?
No, they're not cool.
Fucking sick of waiting, but listen to me. I'm gonna go now and then I'll come back when it's cool. Did you wear that car then? What a fucking racket. Listen to me. I'll go now. I'll come back when the cakes are cool. When I put the chocolate on, and I'm gonna do some nice fancy, and I'm gonna get one of them sacks with icing in. And what are them sacks called with icing? Where you going?
Out with
dogs. Roger's going out with dogs. Look, you look like you're going to Pemberest with that cold. Is it that cold? You look like going to
Pemberest. I'm going off cliff top. It will be cold.
Are you taking my
Brian
dog?
Brian got my thermos on, like you yet.
Are you taking my dog?
Yes, I always do, Donna.
Thank you. Little Saxon's going with her. But yeah, I'm going to go now, and I'll be back when the cakes are cool.